क्वेश्चन इज, ए 41-year-old मैन कंप्लेन्स टू इज फिजिशियन अबाउट जेट लैग वेन एवर ही फ्लाइज लॉन्ग डिस्टेंसेस टू मीटिंग्स। 41 साल का आदमी है और वो कंप्लेन कर रहा है कि उसे जब भी वो लंबी दूरी की यात्रा करता है टू अटेंड हिज मीटिंग्स ही सफर्स जेट लैग, उसे जेट लैग होता है। उसे मेलाटोनिन प्रिस्क्राइब किया गया है। मेलाटोनिन इज प्रिस्क्राइब एज ए वे टू सेट हिज सर्कैडियन रिदम। बेसिकली लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस में जब हम लंबी दूरी एटलोस्ट एक टाइम जोन को क्रॉस कर लेते हैं, एट दैट टाइम वी सफर फ्रॉम ए कॉमन सिम्टम्स रिलेटेड टू सर्कैडियन रिदम। क्वेश्चन इज, सर्कैडियन रिदम इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग न्यूक्लियाई। चॉइस ए आर्कुएट, बी लेटरल, सी पैरावेंट्रिकुलर, डी सुप्राकाइजमेटिक एंड ई वेंट्रोमीडियल। दीज ऑल आर न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ बेसिकली हाइपोथैलेमस। सो नाउ यू हैव टू थिंक व्हाट विल बी द आंसर। क्वेश्चन इज, द सर्कैडियन रिदम इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग न्यूक्लियाई। बेसिकली किस न्यूक्लियाई से ये कंट्रोल होते हैं, ये न्यूक्लियाई के नाम हैं। दिस इज बेसिकली दी हाइपोथैलेमिक। दीज ऑल फाइव मेंशन हेयर आर दी हाइपोथैलेमिक न्यूक्लियाई। दिस इज ए बेसिकली हाइपोथैलेमस के न्यूक्लियाई। सो व्हाट विल बी द आंसर। आंसर इज डी। डी इज सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस। आई एम अगेन शोइंग यू द चॉइसेस। बेसिकली द चॉइसेस वेयर रिलेटेड टू डिफरेंट न्यूक्लियर एंड द आंसर इज सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस। सो फॉर सर्कैडियन रिदम सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस इज, सर्कैडियन रिदम सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कंट्रोलिंग द सर्कैडियन रिदम। एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवन इज, ए वेराइटी ऑफ फिजियोलॉजिकल फंक्शन सच एज अलर्टनेस, स्लीप वेक साइकिल, बॉडी टेम्परेचर, सिक्रीशन ऑफ हार्मोन एग्जिबिट साइक्लिकल एक्टिविटी दैट वरीज ओवर ए 24 आवर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। बहुत सारे ऐसे फंक्शंस हैं जैसे कि हमें स्लीप वेक साइकिल में और अलर्टनेस में, बॉडी के टेम्परेचर, सिक्रीशन ऑफ सो मेनी हार्मोन्स लाइक कॉर्टिसोल, दे एग्जिबिट साइक्लिक एक्टिविटीज दैट वरीज ओवर 24 आवर साइकिल। दीज वेरिएशंस आर कॉल्ड सर्कैडियन रिदम एंड इट इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस। सो सर्कैडियन रिदम सुपरा काइजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस। द चॉइस में और जो दूसरे न्यूक्लियाई दिए गए थे जैसे पैरावेंट्रिकुलर न्यूक्लियाई, पैरावेंट्रिकुलर एंड सुपरा ऑप्टिक न्यूक्लियाई टुगेदर सिक्रीट्स ऑक्सीटोसिन एंड वैसोप्रेसिन। वेंट्रोमीडियल एंड लेटरल न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस, दे कंट्रोल फूड इनटेक। वन इज द हंगर सेंटर, अनदर इज द सेटाइटी सेंटर। आर्कुएट न्यूक्लियस इज बेसिकली कंट्रोलिंग द गोनाडोट्रोपिन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन एंड दस दे आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द रिप्रोडक्टिव बिहेवियर ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव हार्मोन्स इन द मेल्स एंड फीमेल्स। नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस यू सम डिटेल्स अबाउट द न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस। हाइपोथैलेमस के न्यूक्लियाई कौन कौन से हैं इन सब के अलावे और हाउ दे आर अरेंज इन हाइपोथैलेमस। सो दिस इज बेसिकली द वेरियस न्यूक्लियाई ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस। दे आर डिपिक्टेड इन वेरियस कलर्स। आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फ्रंट पोर्शन दैट इज द फॉरमोस्ट फ्रंट एंड फॉरमोस्ट न्यूक्लियाई इन द हाइपोथैलेमस। दे आर क्लोज इन वेरी क्लोज विथ द with the anterior commissure is called as preoptic nuclei. So one nuclei is preoptic nuclei. Ventrolateral part of preoptic nuclei is considered as a sleep promoting area. Then after that there is the region. That region is called as the supraoptic region. And supraoptic region ke andar there are supraoptic, why it is called supraoptic? Because they are situated above the optic chiasm And there are two important nuclei. One is supraoptic nuclei and another is the suprachiasmatic nucleus. So there is a supraoptic and suprachiasmatic nucleus. This is supraoptic and this is basically the suprachiasmatic. SC. I am writing here SC for suprachiasmatic. Then the another nuclei in this region, basically you can see, I am talking about this region. In this region, the other nuclei is the anterior hypothalamic nuclei and paraventricular nuclei. I told you that the paraventricular nuclei and the preoptic and the supraoptic nuclei both contribute for the supraoptic and paraventricular nuclei. These are basically important for the secretion of posterior pituitary hormones, formation of. Then the tubular region, in the tubular region the nuclei are the lateral hypothalamic nuclei, lateral hypothalamic, then there is a posterior, there is a dorsal hypothalamic nuclei, dorsomedial hypothalamic nuclei and the ventromedial hypothalamic. So these are situated in the lateral and the posterior most, it is also called as mammillary region, that contains the nuclei called the mammillary body. Then then there is the posterior hypothalamic nuclei. So there are the two important. Mammillary body is having the medial and the lateral intercalated nuclei. Mammillary body is divided to two. So these are the various nuclei and their arrangements. We need to study. ये भी वही diagram है जो कि ये बता रहा है कि how the different nuclei are arranged in the different regions of the hypothalamus. You can notice here that the along the anterior commissure there is a nuclei called the preoptic nuclei. Then there is the in the supraoptic region there is paraventricular nuclei, anterior hypothalamus, supraoptic and the suprachiasmatic nuclei. Then in the medial and the tubular region there is the lateral hypothalamus, lateral hypothalamic area, then dorsomedial, then there is a ventromedial and lowermost there is a arcuate nuclei. And in the posterior or the mammillary region there is the posterior hypothalamic area and the mammillary body. So these are the various nuclei of hypothalamus. To study the role of suprachiasmatic nuclei, because this question is related to the circadian rhythm, so this is the diagram showing you how the suprachiasmatic nucleus are important for maintaining our circadian rhythm. Suprachiasmatic nucleus is situated is receiving the impulse from the through the retinohypothalamic tract. So when the retina, they receive retinal ganglion cell, they receive the information of light exposure, and that light exposure leads to the stimuli in the basically in the supra and also they also send the impulse to the brain stem, and they send about that signal about the arousal system and similarly the about the suprachiasmatic nucleus. From the suprachiasmatic nucleus, a series of connections from the suprachiasmatic nucleus to the other hypothalamic nuclei, as well as it is connected to the pineal gland, and they allow the pineal gland for release of the melatonin hormone. So one melatonin hormone is secreted. This is the normally secreting hormones in response of some light stimulus, basically, and so that there is whenever is daytime, then it helps us, or in the morning time 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. morning, the it maintains and it signals is it as a basically the signal of the day signal. And this output of the various nuclei along with the melatonin secretion is helpful for the sleep-wake cycle, for the arousal, and output from the REM sleep and the timing and consolidation of sleep. So these are the various actions of the suprachiasmatic nucleus of hypothalamus is important, you can say, in the center of the regulation of the circadian. It sends information to other hypothalamic nuclei as well as pineal gland to maintain the body temperature, as well as secretion of many hormones such as cortisol, and we know the pineal gland also secretes melatonin. So whenever the suprachiasmatic nucleus, it receives the signal from the light signal from the through the retino-hypothalamic tract, and it behaves like the gateway for managing the circadian rhythm. And its efferent part is they send the signal to the initiation of the autonomic nervous systems, which act through the various portions. Then also they act on the other nuclei of hypothalamus, and then the hypothalamus controlling the pituitary, and as well as it also regulates the pineal gland, which regulates the melatonin. In this way, some role of the melatonin is also need to discuss. That melatonin is only secreted whenever there is the inhibition of the light signal. So when the eye receives light, the pineal gland production of melatonin is inhibited, and the hormone produced keep the human awake. When the eyes do not receive light, melatonin is produced in the pineal gland, and the human becomes tired. So this is basically related to the the functions of the selected regions of hypothalamus. जब क्वेश्चन अभी हम आपसे पूछा गया था, बेसिकली द सर्कैडियन रिदम इज रेगुलेटेड बाय व्हिच पोर्शन ऑफ हाइपोथैलेमस, यू कैन नोटिस दैट द सुप्राकाजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस, जो कि यहाँ पे दिखाया गया है, सुप्राकाजमेटिक न्यूक्लियस रिसीव्स इनपुट फ्रॉम द रेटिना एंड कंट्रोल सर्कैडियन रिदम. अदर न्यूक्लिया लाइक द पैराटिकुलर एंड सुप्रा ऑप्टिक न्यूक्लिया, दे रेगुलेट वाटर बैलेंस, दे प्रोड्यूस ADH एंड ऑक्सीटोसिन, देयर डिस्ट्रिक्शन कॉजेज डायबिटीज इंसिपिडस. Paraventricular nucleus project to the autonomic nuclei of the brain stem and the spinal cord. Regarding anterior nucleus, it is helpful for the thermoregulation. Anterior nucleus is helpful for the thermoregulation. It is responsible for the dissipation of heat. It stimulates parasympathetic nervous system, and its destruction result in the hyperthermia. The preoptic nuclei, it is contains sexually dimorphic nucleus and contains the release of gonadotropin hormone. This is also under the gonadotropin hormone releasing is also under the control of the arcuate nucleus, which also contains the dopaergic neuron that inhibits the prolactin secretion, as well as they produce the various hypothalamic releasing factors. Another nuclei that is called dorsomedial nuclei, they are basically their stimulation results in obesity and savage behavior. It is that's why it is called as the hunger center. The another nuclei of hypothalamus is the posterior nucleus. This is responsible for the thermal regulation, conservation of heat, and its destruction results in inability to thermoregulate, and it stimulates the sympathetic nervous system. Lateral nucleus of hypothalamus, they stimulates their stimulation induces eating, and then its destruction results in starvation. About the mammillary body, they receive input from the hippocampal formation and fornix, and they project to the anterior nucleus of thalamus. In this way, they are important part of the limbic system. And ventromedial nucleus is also called as satiety center, and its destruction results in the obesity as well as the savage behavior. So these are the functions of the selected regions of hypothalamus.